Grace, mercy, and peace. Welcome, welcome, welcome to Fresh Touch International Ministries, where God wants to give you a fresh touch. This is yours truly, Bishop Dr. Mitchell L. Foster. Oh God, there is definitely a word from the Lord on this morning, early morning at 9 o'clock. There is definitely a word, watch this now, for the Lord. I want to God begin to literally download some things in me. And one of the things that he said is that he has placed, watch this now, my brothers and sisters, he has placed your life under the hand of God. Oh, that's powerful. Let me say that again. He has placed your life, watch this now, under, watch this now, the hand of God. Now, let's begin to dissect then what does that mean. Now, 1 Peter 5:6 says, humble yourself. Most people, if you want to experience, watch this now, the hand of God, you must humble yourself. Let me say that again. Hallelujah. If you want this grace to be upon your life, you must humble yourself. It says, humble yourself, therefore, under. So that means as you humble yourself, you must come under, watch this now, the mighty hand of God so that he can lift you up. Oh, God, that's exciting already. You must know that God wants to lift you up. Hallelujah. Can I tell somebody that your season is about to change? I know that some of us have been going through some difficult situations, but I come to tell you, hallelujah, as God's mouthpiece, that your season is about to shift. Solomon says, it is a time for everything. I know that things have not gone according to what you plan, but I'm telling you that the hand of God is shifting over your situation. It's shifting over your finances. It's shifting over your family. It's shifting over everything that is connected to you. Hallelujah. There is a new thing about to happen in your life. And the new thing is that God's outstretched hand is over your life. Can I tell somebody, I've been telling our listeners, hallelujah, that the portals of heaven are being opened. Even as this is Pentecost weekend, hallelujah, you're about to see a release of the Holy Spirit or a measure of him that you've never seen before. Hallelujah, you are about to witness some things in your life that the Holy Spirit will orchestrate that you've never seen before. It's a new movement. Hallelujah. It's not very new to the Holy Spirit, but it will be new to you. Oh God, that's exciting already. And so what? You say, well, what, Bishop, is in this hand? What then is in this hand of God? Hallelujah. I know this year has been rough. I know this year has been tough, but Bishop, come on, tell me what's in this hand. Can I tell you what's, first of all, is in his hand, a heart of God. Not only is a heart in his hand, there is keys. Hallelujah. Let's go. Let's go somewhere. I'm going to take you somewhere. If you would go with me, watch this now, to Proverbs, hallelujah, chapter 21. Proverbs chapter 21. I'm telling you that God is about to open up his hand over your life. You are about to see some supernatural things. I'm speaking prophetically to you. You are about to walk in, hallelujah, unmeasured grace. Hallelujah, grace. Hallelujah, that will have your eyebrows jumping up. Hallelujah. But watch what he says in Proverbs chapter 21. Watch this now. He says, the king's, oh God, that's exciting already. He says, the king's heart is in the hand of the Lord. Oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. I don't care what you are going through. God says, hallelujah, I'm about to touch the king's heart. Who am I talking to early this morning? Hallelujah. He said, I'm about to touch the king's heart. He said, it'll be like rivers of water who turns it whatever he wishes. Every way a man is right in his own eyes, but the Lord weighs the heart. He said, I'm about to turn, watch this now, some things around in your life. Oh God, I know, hallelujah, that you think you can't get that loan. I know that you think you can't get that house. I know that you think you can't get that promotion. I know that you think, hallelujah, that things are not working out. He said, but I'm about to touch the king's heart. I'm about to cause some reversals to happen in your life. Oh, come on, somebody. Somebody can say amen even right there. Hallelujah. The Bible says that the king's heart is in, watch this now, is in the hand of God. Hallelujah. It's in God's hand. Hallelujah. And some of us are up all time of night. We're worrying about this. We're worrying about that. But God said, I control the king's heart. Hallelujah. Because he says, I can do exceedingly, abundantly, above all you think. Why? Because of the power that worketh down on the inside of you. So if you're going to activate this grace, hallelujah, this unprecedented favor, this grace that he's talking about is miracle working grace. This grace, hallelujah, may be different from any grace that you've never experienced before. Even if we are in the week of Pentecost, hallelujah, of seeing the power of God begin to manifest in your life like you've never seen before. But he says to us, hallelujah, to walk in this type of grace, to walk in this type of anointing, you must humble yourself. You got to humble yourself because my mighty hand is stretched out over your life right now. I place your life under my hand. Hallelujah. And there is things, hallelujah, that I have in my hand that I want to disperse in your life. But you must come under my hand. You must come under what I'm trying to do in your life. You must come under that. And you will begin to see this grace that you've never seen. Watch this now. Oh God, before I'm about to do something great in your life. Oh God, somebody say amen. God is about to do something. Watch this now. Greater in my life. Psalms 145. Psalms 145 verse number 16. Psalms 145 verse 16. He says, hallelujah, I'm going to open my hand and satisfy, watch this now, the desires. Oh God, the desires. Oh, y'all got to get this. The desires of every living thing. Oh God. He says, I'm about to open up my heart and, oh God, he said, I know that you've had, watch this now, some desires. I know, watch this now, that you've had some things that you've been asking me for. Oh God, but I'm about to open up my hand to give you access into those. Oh God, into those places. You have had hindrance. You have had obstacles. You have had things that have blocked you from having access. But now, today, I'm opening up my hand. I'm getting ready, says the Spirit of the living God. Hallelujah, to satisfy your desires. Oh, come on, somebody. I know every person that's listening, you got some desires. You've got some things that you want God to do. But God is saying today, I'm going to meet those desires. Hallelujah. How does he meet them? By opening up his hand. Oh God, it takes me, watch this now, to 2 Samuel chapter number 9. Now, we've been talking about this, hallelujah, this grace, this favor. We've been talking about humbling yourself under the mighty hand of God. We've been talking about, watch this now, hallelujah, if you're going to walk, hallelujah, in this, you must come under the mighty hand of God, because when you come under his mighty hand of God, he says, in due time, watch this now, I'm going to exalt you. Oh, come on, somebody. Somebody that's listening today feels like God has forgotten about them. Somebody listening today feels like there's nothing happening in their life, but I come to tell you that God's been working behind the scene. God's been moving things on your behalf. Now, watch this now. As we pick up in chapter number 9, hallelujah, verse number 1, it says, now David, everybody know who David is. David says, is there still anyone who is left of the house of Saul? Oh, God, that I may show him kindness. Oh, here's that grace. Watch this now. Here's that grace that will shift your life. Here's that grace, hallelujah, that will cause things to change in your life. Here's that grace. Watch this now. That even though I did not deserve it, God still shows me kindness. Hallelujah. How many people out there that are listening say, God, that's me. Locate me, God. I'm the one that needs to be located in this season. Hallelujah. Locate me this morning, God. Show me that type of kindness. Show me that type of grace. Somebody needs to type, show me, God. Show me. But my life has been cloudy, God. My life has been where it's hard for me to see. Hallelujah. But God, I'm telling you, in this season, God is about to show, hallelujah, his kindness. He's about to show you a side of him that you've never seen before. Hallelujah. Locate me, God. I've been hurting, God. I've been in pain, God. But locate me, God. Oh, God, 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 locate me, God, locate me. And the Bible says, and there was a servant of the house of Saul whose name was Ziba. And they had called him to David, and the king said, now watch this now. The king now, you have to understand, hallelujah, the king now is talking about you, and you don't even know the king is talking. That's how favor is. Favor can be talking about you, and you don't even know it. You all jacked up, but God is working behind the scene, because favor, hallelujah, is trying to get in position, watch this now, to bless you. Oh, God, this is good all by itself. So then the king said, remember what I said. God holds the heart of the king. David now is a king. Oh, God. Oh, God, I got to slow my roll down. He says, then the king said, hallelujah, because God holds the heart of the king. Then the king said, is there not still someone, watch this now, of the house of Saul, to whom, watch this now, the king now, because God holds the king's heart. God's now dealing with the king's heart. He said, is there not anybody? I want to bless right now. Is there anybody that have tagged in? Hallelujah, that have logged in? I want to bless them. Is there anybody here? Somebody. He said, that I want to show kindness to. That's what God is saying today. I want to show kindness to somebody. I'm going to show kindness of God. And Ziba said to the king, there is still a son of Jonathan, oh God, who is lamed in his feet. Oh God, my God. So the king said to him, where is he? Oh God. See, God's now dealing with the king. Watch this now on your behalf. Watch this now. And Ziba said to the king, indeed, he is in the house of Maacah, the son of Amalek, and in Lodabar. Let me just pause there. Hallelujah. I know a lot of us, we might not admit it, but some of us have been in Lodabar. We've been in a place, hallelujah, where we felt like nothing was going right. We've been in a place that we felt like, hallelujah, things were not turning, things were not shifting. Hallelujah, looking at everybody else being blessed. I'm lame, and I'm not lame because of me. I'm lame because of somebody else. Oh God. I said, I'm not lame because of me. I'm lame because of somebody else. Hallelujah. Somebody else did this to me. Hallelujah. Somebody else. Hallelujah. I'm not lame. I'm not in this position because of me. I'm in this position because of you. Oh, come on, somebody. And the Bible says, and King David says, sin. Hallelujah. Go get him. Can I tell you that grace is getting ready to come get you? Oh, come on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I never realized this when I was on drugs. I never realized it. Hallelujah. When I was out there in the world, but grace came and got me. Oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. God wanted to show me kindness. God wanted to show me that he was who he said he was. He's getting ready to show some of us that I am who I say I am. I can be whatever I need him to be. He said, he that cometh to God, first of all, must believe. Believe what? That he is a rewarder of them that will diligently seek him. He says, I'm going to give you a blank check, but I want to find somebody in spite of. See, you ain't got to be all dressed up. He said, I just want you to come. Now, watch this now. Mephibosheth, he was lame. Hallelujah. He was in a bad condition. He was going through some things. Many folk in the world, we're lame, we're dysfunctional, and we feel like God can't use us. We feel like because we made some mistakes, hallelujah, God, hallelujah, don't have anything for us. But God says, in this season, my hand is open up over your life. I know you made some mistakes. I know you didn't dot every I. I know you didn't dot across every T, but I'm about to show you some kindness. I'm about to let you know that I'm God all by myself. Hallelujah. There are so many people that have tried to take my glory, that have tried to take, hallelujah, who I am. But I'm about to show, hallelujah, the people of God that I am who I say I am. So the Bible says in verse number 6, he says, now when Mephibosheth, the son of Jonathan, the son of Saul, had come to David, he fell on his face. Hallelujah. And prostrate himself. Then David said, Mephibosheth, he answered, where is your son? Let me tell you something. When grace begins to show up in your life, hallelujah, you can't do nothing but fall on your face. Falling on your face, hallelujah, is a level of being humble. Falling on your face is a level of surrender, saying, I can't live in Lodabar anymore. I can't live in this situation anymore. It's tormenting my mind. I got to come out of this situation. So God now sends, watch this now, grace, I'm telling you, he's getting ready, hallelujah, to show you kindness that you've never seen before. You're getting ready to see the mercy of God that you've never seen before. I'm telling you, portals of heaven are open up over your life. Hallelujah, stop looking at, hallelujah, what you did. Hallelujah, and look at where he's about to take you. Unmerited favor, things that I didn't even deserve. I didn't deserve to wake up this morning, but God woke me up. I didn't deserve that he keeps blessing me over and over and over again, just like he's about to bless you. He says here, here is your servant. So David says, do not fear. Let me tell you something. When God is about to usher this type of favor, this type of grace in your life, don't allow fear to paralyze you. You said, then what is fear? It's false evidence appearing real. The enemy wants to paralyze you. He does not want what's on the inside of you to begin to come out. Hallelujah. I'm telling you that the outstretched hand, the hand of God, there's portals over you right now. The outstretched hand, and God is pouring out unmerited favor. Hallelujah. For those that will come under, hallelujah, this favor, those that will come under this grace, hallelujah. He ain't looking for arrogant people. He ain't looking for people that are puffed up. He's looking for people, hallelujah. The world gets so caught up. You got to look a certain way, hallelujah. You got to dress a certain way, hallelujah. But he's looking for people that their hearts are turned toward him. Oh, God, can I teach this thing? Hallelujah. So David says to him, do not fear him. Do not fear. Hallelujah. I see fear about to come in your life. I tell people all the time, sometimes you don't want what's good and you'll sabotage. Hallelujah. When God is about to do, because some of us, you will prefer to stay in the drama. But I'm coming out of Lodabar today. Lodabar, you have no permission to hold me. I'm evicting you today out of my mind, out of my spirit. I'm evicting you today because grace, hallelujah, has located me. Oh, grace has located me today. I don't care. It wasn't the preacher. It wasn't the teacher. It was God. He allowed grace, unmerited favor. Oh, God, hallelujah, to locate me. Watch this now. Watch this now. Watch this now. Oh, God. So David said to him, do not fear, for I will surely show you kindness. How could David say that? Oh, God, how could David say, I'm going to show you kindness? Because, God, I told you that the heart of the king is in God's hand. Oh, God, I don't know what king has been trying to control your destiny. Oh, God, I don't know what king has been trying to control your destiny. But God said, I've been dealing with the king's heart. There's been some things that are about to change in your life. Hallelujah. Because the king, hallelujah, heart has been dealt with. He said, I will surely show you kindness for Jonathan, for your father's sake. Hallelujah. I will restore. Watch this now. Here we go. He said, I will restore. Oh, come on, somebody. I will restore. Somebody needs to say, God, I know that you located me now. Now restore it. I'm going to restore everything that the kangaroo stole. I'm going to restore. You have just entered into a season. I'm telling you that God said, I'm going to restore things in your life. Watch this now. He said, I know that somebody dropped you. Oh, come on. I don't know who dropped you. I don't know who you had your confidence in. Hallelujah. I know it wasn't your fault. I know some things that have happened. Hallelujah. But somebody dropped you. Somebody that you, hallelujah, thought you could depend on. Hallelujah. Is not there anymore. But God said, I'm orchestrating some things in your life. Hallelujah. But I'm about to restore unto you all the land. Oh, come on, somebody. Somebody say he's about to restore land. Oh, come on. Y'all know it's on land. Land is property. Somebody, I'm talking to you today. God has already located you. And because he's located you, he's getting ready. His hands are open. His hands was once closed over your life, but his hands are now open. He says, I'm going to restore. Not only am I going to restore, hallelujah, to you all the land of Saul, your grandfather, and you shall eat bread. Watch this now. At my table, everybody's not allowed at the king's table, but I'm about, hallelujah, to allow you to mingle at the king's table. I'm talking to somebody. I'm about to usher you into a place that you would have never imagined. I'm about to let you eat bread, hallelujah, that you never thought you would eat, hallelujah, but I've been preparing you. You thought while you were in Lodabar that you was about to lose your mind, but I was still preparing the king's heart. Watch this now. And verse 8, as he bowed himself, oh God, as he bowed, hallelujah, himself in a sign of where he said, what is your servant that you should look upon? Hallelujah, a dead dog. Watch this now. Hallelujah, some of us think that we're dead. Oh, come on, somebody. But you ain't a dead dog. Sometimes we got to die so that we can live. Oh, let me say that again. You got to die so that you can live. Hallelujah. And the Bible says, and king called for Ziba. Saul's servant said to him,
I have given to your master's son all that belongs to Saul in his house. Can I tell somebody my next point? And I'm about out of here. Hallelujah. There's coming a release. Hallelujah. God is about to give you some things that you never would have thought you would have never thought you would have been able to get in this lifetime. Hallelujah. And the Bible says in verse number 10, you therefore, your sons and your servants shall work the land that I'm about to give you, the place where I'm about to give you. You got to work it. Hallelujah, says the Spirit of the living God. But Mephibosheth, your master's son, shall eat the bread at the table always. And Ziba had 15 sons, hallelujah, and 20. And Ziba said to the king, according, watch this now, to all my Lord, the king has commanded my servant. So what your servant do, hallelujah. So Mephibosheth, hallelujah, hallelujah, dwell in Jerusalem, for he ate continuously at the king's table. And can I tell you that you are going continuously eat at the king's table. God, hallelujah, is doing something different in your life. Hallelujah. Unmatched, bigger, better. This favor you've never received before. This type of favor, hallelujah, will change things in your life. This type of favor, hallelujah, will cause that, hallelujah, which tried to keep you in bondage. It will break, watch this now, every bondage off of you. Somebody need to type, locate me, hallelujah, favor of God, hallelujah, for the favor of God is about to locate you. The hand of God has been open, just like an open heaven. His hands, oh God, his hands is open over your life. So if his hands is open, he's going to free you for some things. I know it's been hard, but he's located you today. Somebody say, well, Bishop, how do you know that he's located? You're on here today. Oh, God. He located you. That's why you're on. He's located you today so that he can give you something that you need. Because can't nobody else give you what you need right now. I've tried everything, and this thing still is here. I tried to do this, but I'm still in Lodabar. But he says, there's a king that can be controlling that. But I've been touching his heart, because why? He has located you. Today, your season has changed. Your season has changed today. You will no longer be in Lodabar because he's located you. God bless you, my brothers and sisters. I just wanted to give you 30 minutes of power this morning on this beautiful day. May God's word continue to bless you. If you want to always sow, it's Cash App Bishop Foster. Remember this, that God's mighty hand is upon you. God bless you. May your day be blessed. And I am praying for you. Remember, God wants to give you a fresh touch. Amen and amen.